strange parallel. Strange parallel. Strange parallel.
Excuse me. Have you seen Elliott Smith?
Day here in Portland. We've been looking for Elliott Smith on and off, going to different bars. He keeps giving us almost the right address.
Stares into space like a dead China doll. I'm never gonna know you now, but I'm gonna love you anyhow.
So do you have a hard time finding Elliott? Like you know, getting a hold of him and stuff. He's like so vague when he leaves us directions and stuff.
Yes, I do. Everything from a phone to a pager. Even just ask him to get like a voicemail system and I'll leave messages on there.
Now she's done and they're calling someone. Such a familiar name. I'm so glad that my memory's remote. 'Cause I'm doing just fine, hour to hour, note to note. Here it is, the revenge to the tune. You're no good, you're no good, you're no good, you're no good. Can't you tell that it's well understood?
Elliott came in several times. We became friendly. I didn't know he was writing songs. Very quiet. A real gentleman.
I'm never gonna know you now, but I'm gonna love you anyhow.
You were saying that people here.
It's hard to find Elliott.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, if he's in town, they always call here looking for him. His management company and friends and everybody, and usually he's not here.
It's okay, it's alright, nothing's wrong. Tell Mr. Man with impossible plans to just leave me alone in the place where I make no mistakes, in the place where I have what it takes. I'm never gonna know you now, but I'm gonna love you anyhow. I'm never gonna know you now, but I'm gonna love you.
We finally found Elliott. He was recording in Portland, Oregon, a new song he had floating around in the back of his mind.
Misery by Elliott Smith from the Good Will Hunting soundtrack. It's probably been heard by more people, that's for sure.
I thought it was kind of low in the mix of Good Will Hunting, didn't you?
Do you miss me? Miss me like you say you do.
And of course we know. Was nominated for an Academy Award. What surprised me, I was delighted to hear that Elliott and his song was nominated.
Men in the park read the lines in my head, told me I'm strong, hardly ever wrong. I said, men, me, you. Of us that involved a trip out of town to a place I've seen in a magazine.
Later on, we hooked up with Elliott out in New York City. He showed us around his neighborhood and introduced us to a few of his bartenders.
He was a lovely person. I knew very little about him, but we talked, and he was by himself, and sometimes he did some writing. I did not know what he was writing, not when I first met him.
What is it for?
None of your business.
They're making a documentary on me. I play music.
See, I used to come in here as a customer myself. I'm a writer. So when I started working here, I met Elliott. There was sort of a strange parallel.
Constant interviews.
Yeah, and it's probably the worst thing that he has to do in his career. He doesn't think he could do anything else, but he hates interviews.
Have you been listening to a lot of Beatles lately?
I've been listening to a lot of Beatles since I was like 4 years old. But,
what was it like being a musician that sold to a relatively select group of people, the Kill Rogers audiences, and then suddenly being nominated for a Grammy and playing at the Grammys on national TV?
Well, it was the Oscars.
I suppose, who can really tell?
La moda del futuro. It's on the way by muchas partes, y aquí.
It's supposed to be very soulful, and the song to be very, very
very poignant too.
What is this imagery making you think of?
It reminds me of all sorts of things, just like emotionally intense moments in my life.
Like what?
I guess like ex-boyfriends or just my growing up period.
Get your robot hand. Get your robot hand. Robot hand is the future. Get your robot hand.
I wish I'd never seen your face.
Boardroom meetings in our subconscious never really make sense, but they always predict a certain idea that might be real in the future.
Robot hand is the future, Elliot.
Get it, Elliot.
Get the robot hand.
Bottle up and explode over and over. Keep the troublemaker below. Put it away, drag out for the day, in for a round of overexposure, the thing Mother Nature provides, to get up and go, bottle up and explode, seeing stars, surrounding you, red, white.
I turn around. I thought it was dreaming. I saw colors and lights. I felt like I was floating on a cloud. Felt like lying in a forest with tall redwoods. Just floating in space. It's really beautiful.
Can we see your tattoo?
No.
Isn't it a pity? It's a beautiful song. Fucked it up again.
What do you think about the future? What's gonna happen for you?
I think the music business will eventually crush me, but I'm ready.
You like being a popular musician? I mean, semi-popular right now.
I like it better than spreading gravel for a living, you know?
Welcome, my friend. Welcome to the world of Robot Hand. Have you ever asked yourself, what's keeping me between me and my rock idols? What's keeping me from ripping and screaming my way across the mad concert stages of America? I'll tell you, Robot Hand. With the press of a button, you too can rock and rip and tear in any metal acts in any nightclub in America. You might ask yourself, how come I'm enjoying myself? Well, I'll tell you this, it's all in the hand. Expand your guitar virtuosity immediately with Robot Hand. Just in 3 easy payments of $5,999, you can be ripping and screaming and dialing your way across the stage. To rock and unite America, you too can join the world storm that is Robot Hand. Robot Hand, it's the future, grab it now. Yes, my friend, it's available to you too, for Robot Hand. Void where prohibited.
Order your Robot Hand now. No credit cards, please. Send cash only. Just 3 payments of $599.99. Order yours today.
Usually when we go on tour, we open up as Quasi, and then we sort of reconfigure all the instruments and play as his backup band.
Down in the alley, haven't had enough of it all. Said you can do what you want to, whenever you want to.
Favorite band from Portland?
Quasi?
I don't know. What did you talk to LA about his influences? Did he?
You mentioned some names. Quasi.
That's a good place to start, I guess. I mean, yeah, I'm sure he learned everything he knows from us.
He likes people listening to his stuff, and I think that's
great.
Yeah,
he likes people paying attention to him.
Yeah, and then they actually did even before. We had Good Will Hunting on the, you know, out in the marketplace. I would go to shows and they were like packed with like, you know, just all kinds of people partying, and Elliott would start to play and they would all just like quiet down.
She might never have to know anyone. Made her life a lie, you know.
Thank you.
Love life.